you ever need to combine data that's in multiple columns into one, Microsoft Excel's TOCOL function has you covered. This works for Excel for M365, Excel M365 Mac, and Excel for the web. Over in column B and column C, I've got two different group of names. I need to combine them. I'm going to go to cell E2 for our first example. We will do equal TOCOL tab. What do you want to pick up? I'm going to highlight the entire range B2 to C10 and just press enter. And there are the names all listed straight down from E2 down to E19. Example number two of this function. What happens if I have a blank inside my data? I'm going to go ahead and click on Nancy Drew in cell C6 and press the delete key. And if you notice, over in column E, E11 now has a zero, so it is picking up the blanks and returning a zero. To avoid the zeros, go to cell F2. We're going to start off exactly as before, equals TOCOL, highlight the data again. This time, we're going to do a comma. We're on the second argument, the ignore argument. This is an optional argument. But right here is ignore blanks with the number one. And that is it. So now we have one less person in column F than we do in E because we're not picking up the blanks. Another issue you could have, let me come over here and just make something up. I'm going to do equal J1 divided by J2. And I've got an error message now. Look over in column E and F, and I'm showing the error popping in there, and I don't want it. So over in G2, same steps. We're going to pick up the entire range. On for argument number two, we're going to do the number two, which says ignore errors. And there we go. Now, we still picked up the blank, if you notice that, in cell G11. Now we're getting the blank, and there's a zero. So finally, one more. I'm over in H2, pick up the data, and you've probably already going to figure out what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the number four. I'm sorry, I'm going to do the number three. Number three says ignore blanks and errors. And that is really probably what I would be using right there. One last bonus tip, and I haven't covered this yet. Let me just make this the fifth one. Right now, if you notice, I'm going to just look back in any one of these. It goes from left to right. So it picked up cell B2, went over to cell C2, went to cell B3, then went over to C3. It's working left to right in the columns. Well, maybe I want to go straight down column B first and then come back and go down column C. Go to cell I2. Equal TOCOL, highlight all your information. For argument two, for ignore, we're still going to do a three, comma. We're on the third argument, and then again, this is an optional one. It says scan by column. Instead of false, which is the default, I'm going to do true. Now, if you notice, over in I, this one is different. It's going Chris, Art, on and on, straight down. So it's going straight down column B first, then coming back and doing column C. My Microsoft Excel training is available online, including Teams, OneNote, and Copilot. Everyone have a wonderful day. Thank you.